Every new month brings a guarantee of fresh original Netflix programming, but March 2019 is going to be the mother load. With a grand total of 60 Netflix originals heading onto the streaming service, you're all but guaranteed to find something new to fall in love with. No matter how you break it down, there's going to be a ton of streaming options crashing onto Netflix over the next 31 days. So we picked through the mass of new originals to come up with the best, most exciting, and most original Netflix releases for March 2019. History generally focuses on the winners, but what about those men and women who poured their hearts and souls into something only to come up short? What about the losers of history?
You are one pathetic loser. No offense.
But what if it's our losses that give us strength to keep fighting? That's what Netflix's upcoming documentary Losers wants to know. By looking at the people who didn't bring home the top prize, Losers explores what lessons we can all learn from, well, losing. Take a look on March 1st. Directed by and starring Chiwetel Ejiofor, The Boy Who Harnessed the Wind tells the dramatic story of a 14-year-old boy in Malawi who builds a wind generator to help his famine-stricken village. The film dropped at Sundance in January 2019 to extremely positive reviews and snagged the Alfred P. Sloan Feature Film Prize in the process. If the premise sounds familiar, that's because it's based on the real-life story of William Kemkwamba, who went on to give a TED Talk about his experiences bringing electricity and irrigation to his village. Get ready for a powerful hit of emotion when The Boy Who Harnessed the Wind blows onto Netflix on March 1st. The political thriller Secret City largely flew under the radar when it premiered on Netflix in June 2018, but the critical reception was overwhelmingly positive. Dark and cerebral, Secret City follows a journalist, played by Anna Torv, who digs too deep while investigating a government conspiracy. The second season promises more of the same suspense and political intrigue as the first season. Take a look on March 6th. On the heels of hit supernatural shows like Sabrina and Umbrella Academy, Netflix is dropping the first season of The Order. The show centers on a college freshman who joins a secret society and gets caught up in a battle against evil werewolves, like you do. The trailer for The Order promises a little magic, a little mayhem, and a lot of drama, perfect for binging through those cold March nights. Check it out on March 7th. Anyone familiar with Ricky Gervais's style of comedy should have some idea of what to expect in Afterlife. In the show, Gervais plays a writer whose wife passes away, leading him to adopt a bitter outlook on the world.
If you're watching this, then I'm not around anymore. But don't spiral, don't obsess. Keep going.
Although details about the show have been few and far between, Gervais explained a bit about his character's headspace to SiriusXM's Ron Bennington.
So it's a good guy trying to be a psychopath, because he's hurt.
Dark? Yeah, pretty much. Funny? We hope so. Tune in when Afterlife drops on March 8th. In Formula One Drive to Survive, Netflix is looking behind the scenes of the ultra-competitive world of Formula One racing. This high-octane documentary series puts viewers in the driver's seat to experience the thrill of victory, the despair of defeat, and the white-knuckle adrenaline of one of the fastest sports on four wheels. Anchoring it all are the stories of the dedicated drivers who put their lives on the line for glory, fame, and fortune. Formula One Drive to Survive races onto Netflix on March 8th. According to the Netflix series page, Immortals is about a vampire who's out for vengeance against the leader of her own kind, a ruthless killer who's attempting to gain immortality. And sure, another modern-day vampire yarn doesn't exactly bleed originality, but we're hoping this turns out to be worth watching. Find out on March 8th. South African cinema hasn't had a whole lot of representation on Netflix, but that's set to change with the addition of the Netflix original Shadow. Part cop drama and part vigilante justice, Shadow focuses on a former policeman who is struck by lightning and loses the ability to feel pain. What else would you do with a power like that besides go after the city's bad guys one by one? But if Dexter taught us anything all those years ago, it's that the real police force doesn't always like having a rogue criminal catcher on the loose.
He's playing God, and sooner or later he's going to fall from his tower.
Will he be able to make a dent in crime when he's being pursued by both sides of the law? Find out when the action-packed new series premieres on March 8th. Ben Affleck headlines Triple Frontier as a retired soldier who gets pulled into a criminal heist when one of his war buddies decides to get their old crew together. His plan is to take out a drug cartel boss and rob his house. Of course, that's the kind of plan that's bound to go disastrously wrong, and you can probably expect plenty of twists as the story unfolds.
A lot more people are gonna come after you.
You lied to us.
Oscar Isaac and Charlie Hunnam co-star in Triple Frontier, which hits Netflix on March 13th. Arrested Development has come a long way from its beginnings as a troubled Fox series to its current status as a Netflix original. As the third season of the original series faced cancellation due to a dwindling audience, the showrunners even worked a few cries for help into the story itself.
Instead of us all selling out and becoming housewives and waiters, why don't we have a big event?
Some sort of Save Our Bluths type thing.
Fortunately, Netflix finally picked up the show in 2006, streaming all three original seasons while filming a fourth and fifth season. On March 15th, you can check out the final half of season 5. If you miss it, there'll only be one thing you can say.
I've made a huge mistake.
Burnout follows a professional motorcycle rider who's one of the best racers on the track. But when his mom's life is threatened by the criminal underworld, he'll have to use his need for speed to bury drugs, all in the hopes of paying off his mother's debt. Filled with suspense and motorcycle chases, Burnout looks like a great film for any action lovers out there. Saddle up when Burnout arrives on March 15th. What is Love, Death, and Robots? According to Netflix's official description, it's an animated anthology involving, quote, terrifying creatures, wicked surprises, and dark comedy. That sounds interesting, and even more intriguing is the fact that Love, Death, and Robots comes from David Fincher and Deadpool director Tim Miller. Animation or not, you'll definitely want to put the tots to bed before queuing up any of these mature shorts. For his part, Tim Miller has called the project a labor of love, saying that he's excited that the creative landscape has finally changed enough for adult-themed animation to become part of a larger cultural conversation. Take a look when all 18 episodes of Love, Death, and Robots drop on March 15th. The initial news of a revival of the mid-aughts makeover show Queer Eye for the Straight Guy was met with mixed responses. But in the true spirit of the show, the modern makeover turned out to have just the right stuff for today's world. With a new Fab Five with expertise in design, culture, and fashion, Queer Eye showed that it was willing to delve deeper than a superficial makeover, tackling issues like homophobia, racism, and police profiling.
I loved the Fab Five. They made me feel great.
Season 2 was met with the same positive response, and now fans are gearing up for a third season, which drops on March 15th. Motley Crue has spent almost four decades shaking stadiums with their mix of heavy metal and glam rock. But even more than their music, the band was all too often known for their hard-rocking lifestyles filled with drugs and parties. Based on the band's own autobiography, The Dirt offers a cinematic look behind Motley Crue's music. It's sure to be a pulse-pounding biopic, and you can take the ride on March 22nd. The suburban zombie comedy Santa Clarita Diet shouldn't work as well as it does, but fans have spent two seasons growing to love the characters of this quirky, funny, and occasionally graphically violent show.
That was a crazy amount of vomit.
Well, I'm not a medical expert, so I can't say what the proper amount of vomit is.
It was a huge amount.
For those who haven't caught the bug yet, Santa Clarita Diet stars Drew Barrymore as a real estate agent who's unfortunately turned into a zombie. It's up to her husband, played by Josh Duhamel, to help her satisfy her hunger for human flesh, while also making sure they all keep up the standards of their upper-middle-class lifestyle.
Excuse me, I gotta go lie to a cop and tell him I murdered somebody so I don't get in trouble.
Tune in for Season 3 on March 29th. The story of Bonnie and Clyde is the stuff of legends, and like most legends, it's been adapted for film and television way too many times. The outlaw lovers even got the campy revised history treatment with Bonnie and Clyde vs. Dracula. When your true story of love and murder needs vampires to liven it up, you know it's been done to death. So what makes The Highwaymen different? For starters, it shifts the focus from Clyde Barrow and Bonnie Parker onto Frank Hamer and Manny Gault, two aging Texas Rangers who joined the hunt for Bonnie and Clyde and were eventually responsible for bringing them down. Woody Harrelson and Kevin Costner take the lead roles, promising a gritty, emotional detective drama. Take a look when The Highwaymen lands on March 29th. Comedy fans will have plenty to look forward to this March, with four new stand-up specials joining the streaming service. For starters, look for the political comedy show Patriot Act with Hasan Minhaj, airing every week starting March 3rd. On the 12th, tune in for British comedian Jimmy Carr's The Best of Ultimate Gold Greatest Hits. After that, Amy Schumer's bringing her newest special, Growing, on March 12th, and Nate Bargatze drops an hour of stand-up on the 26th with The Tennessee Kid. Those are all the best Netflix originals to look forward to. Now, here are some new movies hitting the service in March. Two kung fu masterpieces and an off-the-wall family adventure mark Netflix's action editions this March. On the first of the month, Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon sails onto the service. On the 8th, gather up the family and queue up Spy Kids 2, The Island of Lost Dreams, easily one of the most bizarre family films in recent history.
Smells like the work of Donegan Giggles.
And on the 15th, don't miss Stephen Chow's hilarious action comedy, Kung Fu Hustle. Speaking of comedy, March is all about the classics, with 2001's ridiculous farce Wet Hot American Summer showing up on the 1st, followed by the horror comedy Tucker and Dale vs. Evil on the 29th.
He looks like he's gonna walk it off. He's gonna be fine.
There will also be some more serious fare arriving in March. On the 1st, relive the indie thriller that put Jennifer Lawrence on the map, Winter's Bone. This haunting mystery revolves around a young girl on the hunt for her father in the Ozarks and features a powerhouse performance from Lawrence as the lead character. There will be plenty of new drama additions as well. On the 1st of the month, keep your eyes peeled for Stanley Kubrick's A Clockwork Orange, Apollo 13, and The Hurt Locker, among others. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more Looper videos about your favorite stuff are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.